Welcome to our seventh and final portion of our lesson. This section is entitled The Difference Between Vector and Raster Artwork, and it's brought to you by Printwand. So we've gotten a lot of good information in the previous six sections of our video. We're going to end our lesson here by discussing the differences between a vector and rasterized based image. If you've ever been asked for a document that needs to be specifically one or the other, it's important to note the differences. And for this portion of the video, we're going to be using Photoshop, but we're also going to need to use Illustrator as well. So here we are in Illustrator, and we have a piece of artwork that we're looking at. First, let's select our image by going up to our menu bar, head to Select, and then All. Now we want to zoom in real tight on our artwork, as high a zoom as we can. We do this by heading over to our toolbar on the left here, and the zoom tool is located at the very bottom of the menu. Simply click in the middle of the selection of our artwork here, and we're going to zoom in very tight on our image. So we can see how smooth the image is. We get very crisp lines. But let's zoom back out now, and we do this by heading up to our menu bar. We'll go down to View, and then Actual Size. So when we zoom out, we can see that this image is actually made up of a series of points, and this is what creates the piece of artwork. Because of that, we can grab this image and resize it as much as we want. It's always going to maintain its resolution and clarity. If we zoom back in, we notice that it's still very sharp and crystal clear. So now let's go ahead and flip over to Photoshop, where we can look at a raster image. And here we have a similar image to the one that we were looking at in Illustrator. Let's get our zoom tool the same way that we would have here over in Illustrator, and we're going to zoom in pretty tight on the image to see what we get here. So notice how, as soon as we get over 100% or so, the image starts to get fuzzy. Now this is because rasterized art is actually made up of individual pixels. Let's go back over to our menu bar, we'll go to View, and then Actual Pixels, so we can get our zoom level back to normal. So here what we've done is imported a layer from Illustrator so that we can see the difference between these two files. Let's click in the left-hand area of the box so we can hide our original layer, and then we'll click our imported layer here to view that. Now this is actually a piece of vector art because it was created in Illustrator. Notice this symbol here on the layer, and that's what indicates that it's a vector. So let's go back to our zoom tool, and we'll get in really tight here on our image. We can see that it still appears fuzzy, the way our raster image did, and that's only because we're viewing it in Photoshop. Let's go back up to our menu bar, go to View, and then Actual, and we're zooming back out here so that we can see our image again. So now we're going to go ahead and enlarge this image, and we want to go maybe more than double its normal size. And this is done by pressing Ctrl-T on the PC or Command-T on the Mac, and you simply drag the handles till you get to the size you want, and then you hit Enter. So here we can see that at 100%, our lines are still crisp and clear. Let's go over to our original raster image, and we're going to do the same. We're going to increase the size on it as well. We'll hide the vector layer, we'll show the raster layer, and again, now we're going to press Ctrl-T on the PC, Command-T on the Mac, grab the handles and enlarge it. So right away, we can see the difference. Notice how fuzzy this image appears at 100%. And if we toggle back and forth between the two images, we get a better feel for how different the two formats really are. So see, these are some of the main differences between the two pieces of art. That way, you're going to know what to look for when someone asks for a piece of vector art or a piece of raster art. Make sure to check back often to PrintWand for more video lessons, as well as other articles to help you with your marketing and promotional needs.